Welcome to a video on determining limits that involve trigonometric functions, and the goal of this video is to determine limits using a variety of techniques. Now, in my video entitled Introduction to Limits, we do discuss what a limit is, and you may want to watch that video first if you haven't already. In general, there are three ways to approach finding limits: the numerical approach, in which we use a t-table to look at values of the function as x approaches c; the graphical approach, where we analyze the graph; and then lastly, the analytical approach, where we use algebra or calculus techniques to find limits. Let's also review the informal definition of a limit. The limit as x approaches c of f of x is equal to L if all of the values of f of x are close to L for values of x that are sufficiently close but not equal to c. And sufficiently close would consist of values that are less than or greater than c. And often we say values that are to the left and to the right of c. Some functions may not have limits at specific values of c, which we'll see in just a second. And lastly, notice the value of the limit is not affected by the value of the function at x equals c. Now, there are three types of behavior for the non-existence of a limit. The first is that the function approaches a different number or a different value from the left and right side of c. Number two, f of x increases or decreases without bound as x approaches c. And lastly, f of x oscillates between fixed values as x approaches c. Let's go ahead and look at a few examples. The limit as x approaches pi over 6 of sine x. Well, here's the graph of y equals sine x. Let's go ahead and identify where x is equal to pi over 6. And that would be this vertical line here. So we want to see if we're approaching the same function value from the right and from the left. Well, since the sine function is nice and smooth and continuous around pi over 6, that tells us that we can perform direct substitution to find the value of this limit. So this limit is equal to the sine of pi over 6. And this should look very familiar to us. Pi over 6 is 30 degrees, so a 30, 60, 90 right triangle would look something like this, where the sine of 30 is equal to the opposite over the hypotenuse, which is equal to 1/2. So this limit is equal to 1/2. Again, these are the kind of limits that we like because we can find them by performing direct substitution. But in many cases, we cannot do this. The limit as x approaches pi over 2 of tangent x. Again, let's identify graphically where x is equal to pi over 2. That would be this vertical line here. So we're approaching this vertical line from the right side in this direction and the left side in this direction. So right away, we can see that we're not approaching the same value. And in fact, the limit as x approaches pi over 2 from the right would be equal to negative infinity. And the limit as x approaches pi over 2 from the left would be equal to positive infinity. So obviously, these do not approach the same value, and they also increase and decrease without bound. Therefore, this limit does not exist. Let's go ahead and take a look at one more. The limit as x approaches 0 of sine 1 over x. Graphically, as x approaches 0, we can see something odd is happening in this region. Let's take a closer look at this by using a t-table. What I want to do here is take a look at the value of 1 over x, which is the argument we're taking the sine of. So this is not the function value, this is just the argument of 1 over x. So if x is equal to negative 0.1, this is the same as negative 1/10. 1 divided by negative 1/10 is the same as 1 times negative 10 over 1. This would give a value of negative 10. And for the same reason, when x is positive 0.1, this would be equal to 10. Next, when x is equal to negative 0.01 or negative 1/100, 1 over x would be equal to negative 100. And this would be positive 100. And these last two columns, as x gets even closer to 0 and takes on the value of negative 0.001, which is negative 1/1000, 1 over x would be equal to negative 1/1000. And this would be equal to 1,000. The next thing I want you to think about is that the period for the sine function is equal to 2 pi, or roughly 6.28. So every 6.28 radians, the sine function takes on all the values between negative 1 and positive 1. So going back to our table, as x approaches 0, 1 over x is actually approaching positive and negative infinity, which means that, remember, every 6.2 radians, the function value will alternate between negative 1 and positive 1. So as we get closer and closer to 0, the function sine of 1 over x is alternating between negative 1 and positive 1 faster and faster and faster. And therefore, because this function alternates between negative 1 and positive 1, as x approaches 0, this limit does not exist. Let's take a look at this on our graphing calculator as well. So in y1, we have sine 1 over x. Let's adjust our window so that the x interval is between negative 3 and positive 3. And the y interval is between negative 2 and positive 2. Let's go ahead and graph it. And again, we can see as x gets closer to 0, it starts to alternate. Let's go ahead and zoom in on this and see what we can discover. So if we press zoom, option 2, and then enter, again, you can see as we're approaching 0, this function is alternating between negative 1 and positive 1. Let's go ahead and zoom in again. And of course, we could keep doing this over and over and over again, but it's becoming very clear, I hope, that this function is alternating between negative 1 and positive 1. Let's go ahead and try it one more time. Zoom in, enter. And it's just alternating faster and faster between negative 1 and positive 1. Okay, I hope you found these explanations helpful. Thank you and have a good day.